गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास नाइन। इनफैक्ट आई से गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास नाइन सेक्शन सी एंड सेक्शन बी। दिस इज योर आईटी टीचर रामचंद्र सर एंड वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर टुडे दैट इज माइक्रोसॉफ्ट एक्सेल। आई थिंक एम एस वर्ड एंड ऑल थिंग्स दोज वीडियोज यू हैव सीन। ओके लेटर ऑन आई विल गिव यू द होल प्रैक्टिकल एज वेल एज थ्योरेटिकल नोट्स। लेट मी सी आई कैन प्रिपेयर आई विल गिव इट टू यू बट टुडे लेट इज स्टार्ट एम एस एक्सेल। ओके लेट सी इन एम एस एक्सेल what the features are there, what the components are there and how to work in this environment, is it? So let us start. In theory class it's okay, in practical, every practical I'll just give one practical demonstrations, right? So better use see it from there, those videos, practical videos, practical hand-on experiments, and you can practice in your system. Okay, right? So let's begin this. Can you tell me what is MS Excel? See, I do have MS Excel here and my version is 2013. You can have any version of MS Excel. In every version some upgradations are there, some interface differences you might be getting. So I'm showing you my version. My version is you see MS 13, MS Office 13, and I mine one is I do have a full version here. This is licensed one, understand? So it is having more features rather than that copied one or pirated one. So nothing to worry about that. You can have generalized features are available in that pirated version also. Nothing to worry about that. Okay, so let us start this. So what is Excel means here? What type of, see, if I'm going to click here, then see what coming here, cells are coming here. This is not a general, or this is not looking like MS Word. In MS Word we are getting one full page, is it? I can show you MS Word here. See MS Word. So in MS Word I'm showing you, see, a page is coming here. Okay, in that page you are going to type, is it? But in MS Excel you go, MS Excel you see, you type, see, something different you are going to have. So the basic difference between MS Word and MS Excel is that in MS Word this is known as text editor. Okay, text means number, characters and all, is it? Number are also in character form. I am going to write here 5 4 3 2 1. So this 5 4 3 2, these all are numbers here, understand? But when we are going to type this in MS Excel, MS Excel is known as number editor, understand? Numerical editing is there here. In MS Word text editing, in MS Excel numerical editing. In this one we can say that it is an electronic presentation of numbers. Okay, it is an interface which can represent numerical facts and figure. Facts and figure, this means anything. Suppose creating budget, customer information, forecasting future, tax, calculating tax, payroll, is it, attendance, okay, which deals with number. And if you see from morning till evening you go outside, so many things are there, so many works are there that depends upon number. Even to market you are getting cash memos, okay, again facts and figure, numbers, total quantity, total price, total amount payable. Okay, so this type of calculation, you go to bank, all numerical calculations are there. So if this type of compiling of numerical data is there, okay, we have to compile the data, we have to analyze the data, and we come up to a proper we can say that we can come up to a proper decision, is it? We can make a decision. And we can represent this numerical facts and figure in multiple ways, such as graph, charts and all, easy to understand. Then this whole is termed as MS Excel, right? So, and it makes our calculation work more easier, Right. Suppose I'm writing here, you see in this cell I'm writing here 12. You might be not knowing what I'm writing here, in where I'm writing here, see 45. I'm writing here 56 here. So one by one I am going to let you know about all these things. So let's start this MS Excel. So can you tell me some features of this MS Excel? We can very easy, we can enter number, we can edit number, we can have a number calculations, we can have a editing, formatting, we can create tables of interrelated numerical data, we can have a mathematical calculation, is it? We can have a charts. You know what are charts? Charts make things more easier to understand and to analysis. Numerical facts and figure much easier, is it? Have you seen some charts in cricket match and all, summaries and all, is it? So you can make a decision by using charts, is it? Later on I'll teach you how to have a chart also. We can organize the data, we can sort the data ascending, descending order like that here. So these all features you are going to get in MS Excel, right? So let us start. First, see the interface or the components of MS Excel. What things you are going to get it, understand? So one by one I am going to show you all. Then you can find it out. Some I had written already here, is it? Many are there, but some common one I had written here, and one by one I am going to let you know all. Okay, so let me have my marker here, then it will be easy, and let me adjust my marker. Okay, this width is good. Okay, now come back here. At the very top, if you see, this is known as title bar. This is known as title bar. Okay, and what this title bar is going to contain? This title bar is going to contain the name of your file. You just check it out. This is the name of your file. Okay, and nowadays this title bar are coming, you know, in this version. In this version you are getting a quick access toolbar is here in this title bar. This is known as quick access toolbar. Somewhere I had written also, you see this quick access toolbar is here. Okay, so in I think 98 version or I think 98 version it is not available there, but 2010 and above all are having title bar. In that title bar, title is also there, as well as quick access toolbar is there. So many options you are going to get it from here. You see undo, redo, save, and if I'll go here, see I'm showing you, if I'm going back here, see so many other options are available in this quick access toolbar. Okay, so nothing to worry, you can increase, you can expand, you can if I want to have a new, then a new will come here, you see, understand? That if I'm going to remove the new, then new will go from here. So this is quick access for you, is it? Done. Next, let's move on. And this title bar also contain, you see, minimize button, then again you see maximize button, this cross button. See, sign is also coming. See, since mine was full version, understand? So you see I can sign to Microsoft. Okay, and again you find out here, this is going to have a online help, you can take help, understand? So got it. And this is close button, you all might be knowing about this. So in right side of the toolbar you have a sign in, you have a minimize button, maximize button, and this exit button, then middle title bar, then here quick access toolbar is here, right? So okay, so this concept is clear. Come back here next. Now after this title bar, next is a set of menus, understand? You see, this is I will not say menu here, because menu is not pop out, rather tabs are the better word, I think, or what, tabs are better. Menu in 98, you see, you click to the file menu, a menu is going to pop down, that is known as menu bar. It is not coming like this here. Okay, suppose I'm going to have a, let me start notepad. I'm going to open the notepad here. So in notepad, you see I am going to click, see a menu is popping down, see a menu pop down here. So this menu, this is known as menu bar. If this type of structure is there, then here menu bar is going to pop down, right? So but here you see menu bar is not popping down, it is popping down here in notepad, understand? I am going to close, but here menu bar is not popping out in this version. Either are you finding? If you are going to click here, then this is going to change the setting of these toolbars. Okay, so in programming technology or programming terminology, right, we are saying this as tabs. Okay, so this is not menu bar. Rather, we can say now this is what tabs. We are not having menu. We are having what tab? Suppose home tab. In home tab, so many commands are here. In insert tab, so many commands are here. In page layout tab, so many commands are like that. So now the format got changed. We are telling this one as a tab. So now need not to say go to home menu. Rather, we say that go to home tab. Understand? And each tab is going to have a associate commands displayed. I am going to show those commands to you. See, suppose I am going to take this home tab. This home tab is active tab now, my here. Home tab is active. So in this home tab, what are the associated commands available here? So you go from here, you go from till last year. These all are the associated commands of this what? Home tab. Like that way, insert tab is there, page layout tab is there, formula is there, then data, review, view, these all tab. All are having different commands options available there. See, click and you can go through it. Right, so you see, okay, everybody, all the tabs are having different sets of commands, is it? Right, now after that, come back here, come back to this working interface. Let me open a new worksheet for you. See, since I written this for you, this writing will take time, understand all the features and all. So I am discussing, okay, so I am going to take a new sheet and here I am going to explain it to you. Okay, so see, after this tabs and commands option, are you finding here this one M11 written there? This is known as cell address bar. Whatever cell you are going to click, it address will go. Or before making this one, I am going to show you one a very common thing, understand? See what cell I am going to click. See, are you getting? Okay, these are not individual pages, rather these are individual cells. This is known as cell. And if I'm going to click here, what will be the location of this cell in the sheet? F4. F is known as column. This is column and this one is row. I will come to detail, understand, for this one. No need to worry about that when I'm going to have a sheet, just right now. So this is address, sorry, name box. Name box is going to have an address of the cell. Okay, see what I'm clicking. See, this is changing. Now it is E6. I'm going to click I4 is here. This is A1 is there. So like that way you can go. You can directly type also here. I am writing A1. Press enter key. See, the that cell become active now. Okay. After this one, we are going to have a formula bar here. This is formula bar. Here you are going to write formula, or rather you are going to write something here that will go to the cell. I am going to show it to you. Whatever you are going to type here, suppose I am going to click here, B2 is my address, and I am going to write here something that I am writing here, computer, is it? Press enter key. You see, you can insert. Okay, so either you can have a double click to write something, or you can click and go to the formula bar to write something, or you can click and press F2 command button to input the data. Three ways are there to input the data. What I'm saying to you, you click here, have a double click, start typing. See, I'm typing, understand? Again, you click here, you go to the formula bar, here you start typing. You see, you are typing. Okay, now you click here, you press F2 button. I'm pressing F2 button from my keyboard, is it? F2 button, is it? Then start typing here, you can type. So these are the three ways to input the data, understand, right? So we have learned this one as a formula bar. Okay, you can write the formula, you can write. Okay, if I say formula here, then you might be wondering what is formula. So I am writing here, you just check. I am writing here equal to 2 plus 3. Just check it out. I haven't written 5. I written here 2 plus 3. So this is the formula bar. You can write the formula here. Later on I will teach you how to write different types of formulas, is it? Okay, come back here again. Next, after this formula bar, come back to this one. This whole area is known as sheet. Okay, Excel sheet consists of what? Cells, understand? What is cells? Cells are intersection of rows and columns. So this is Excel sheet. It consists of column and rows. This one is column and this one is known as what? Rows. So column is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, like that, and it can go endlessly, is it? Now our Excel sheet has got no limit, understand? If I am going to go ahead, you see, after this X, Y, Z, what is coming? A coming, A, B, A, C, A, D. Now after that again A, Z. After A, Z, what will coming? B, A, B, 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 C, B, D, B, Z. Like that will go on, endless. Okay, there is no limit now. And it's up to you. You can add more number of column. You can add more number of rows. But I can show you one last here. You just let me see it will go to the last or not. Okay, so this is coming as the last, but I can add more also. Here you see this is first one A and it is coming last here XFD. Okay, like that same way it is having rows. Rows are starting with numbers, understand? Always remember that column starts with character ABCD and rows start with what? Numbers. Number is 1, 2, 3, 4, like that. If I'm going to click here, this one you see 1, then 2, 3, like that. And I can make to go down here. Let me see the number. So in my sheet here, I am getting here what number? 1, 0, 4, 8, 5, 7, 6. So nothing to worry about that. I can add more number of rows here. So nothing to worry. I am going ahead again in the first one. Let me click the last one here. Okay, then I will go to the top one. So what the basic difference between rows and column? Rows always starts with a character and column always starts with a character and rows always start a number. And wherever they are going to meet, suppose I am going to click here. You see, I am going to click here. G is the column and 8 is the row. So G8 is the address. So whenever they are going to meet, they are going to form what? Cell. Okay, so I am going to show you one cell. Let have this. Okay, so now you check out here. So we have gone through this G and this 8 here. So what is the address of this? It is G8. Okay, so this cell name is G8. Now this cell is going to have data in this. Now here you are going to have a double click and write. Suppose I am going to write here 12. So now I can say that what is the data in G8? 12 is the data in G8. Right, so again I am writing in H8, 23. What is the data in H8, 23? Understand? So like that way we will go on. That's why it is known as spreadsheet. A sheet consists of rows and column. Intersection of row and column is a cell, and cell is what? Representation of a data. You can represent any type of data in this one. Text, number, formulae, then again you can have a logical, relational, is it, data in this one. You can write full text also, no need to worry about that. So any representation go in a what? Cell. Yeah, now you can adjust the cell. You can increase also, you can decrease also. See, I am increasing and decreasing, but the best way is that suppose I am typing here, suppose I typed here and this data go till this much long and I want to adjust the column. This column is what? K. So I will go here. You see my icon is changing here, understand? So I can have a simple double click. This whole column will be selected, you see, according to the width. Have you got clear? Okay. If I'm going to make it close, I can make it close. None. But this doesn't mean that data is here in this L7. Data is here in what? K7. I can write here. See, I can write here. Then in M7, I can write here in the C. All are individual data. Understand? You see, in this one A, this one B, this one C, I written. I can adjust the width also from here. You just check. I had adjusted the width. Okay, but data remains same. Okay, you see data remains same here. This is spreadsheet. It will spread according to your data. Okay, it will automatically adjust. See, it has spreaded or not. Again, if I'm going to manually, I'm going to just make it forced to come closer here, again come closer here. Again, I'm going to have a double click, spread out, again spread out, spread out. So a sheet consists of column, and column can spread out. So this is known as spread sheet, right? So here is cells are active. Come back next again, what things are there here. In this one here, you see this one is sheet tab. Sheet 1 by default, sheet 2 by default. There can be here only 2 is there, but standard is for 3 worksheets. But Office, I think 10 and above, they are giving only 2 sheet by default. Okay, you can add this add sign, click here, one more new sheet will come. Right, so this one is known as vertical scroll bar. This one is known as horizontal scroll bar to navigate the sheet. Okay, and if you see here downside, this is zoom toolbar. Okay, you can zoom your worksheet, and you can make your worksheet to zoom in, zoom out. Different zoom labels are there, understand? And some shortcuts are here, and this is going to here you see these are the shortcuts how you are going to see your MS Excel worksheet, understand? So here I'm showing you, this is zoom. Right now it is 100%. I am going to zoom. You see, I am going to click zoom. See, it is coming bigger for me. This is zooming. Again, I am going to close it. This is again coming. 100% is okay, is it? Now in this one, you see this is page layout. How you are going to see your page? Understand? Again, I am going to click here. You see how it is looking like? Okay. Then again, I am going to click. Again, I am going to click. Is it? So how this page will go on? Right. So this is all about fundamental and components of MS Excel, what we have learned till now. Now I am going to show you how to create a file and how that file will go according to your printer. Okay, so here you see I take a sheet, see a new sheet. I'll go to this file menu, this page layout tab. In this tab you see the setup command is here, page setup command is here. In page layout, the common page setup commands are this one given here. See, and more is given with this drop down arrow. So I am going to click this drop down arrow so that I can go more here. So I clicked here. Okay, I clicked here. I can go to the page setup. Here I am going to set the page paper. I am going to make it A4 so that whatever I do exact, because A4 is the normal printer page. This is portrait, this one is landscape mode. Is it portrait is vertically and horizontally is what landscape. Margins I am setting here. Top bottom left light margin, I am making it to what 0.5. Here also I am going to make here 0.5. And top also I am going to make 0.5. Left also I am going to make 0.5. Okay. Now I am going to make here okay, let's see. So if you see carefully, understand, so one margin has come. You can go through this margin. You see this margin, this margin has come. Okay, so what about this margin? What is margin? This margin will show you your A4 size. If I'm going to minimize little bit, just check, see my worksheet. Now my not worksheet, it's a spreadsheet. So this spreadsheet, you see, this is showing you total number of pages here. You see this dot, this is your first page from here to here. This will be printed first, then this will be printed second one, like that way page go on. And you have to give the command either print in horizontal wise or either print in vertical wise. So this is your page. You have set your page, A4 size page. Done. Okay. Now you start typing. Now whatever you type accordingly, that same will be printed because you have set your printer and you have set your page. See, if I'm going to go down here, I'm going down here. See, page has ended here. So after this one, if I'm going to write something here, then it will go to new page. Okay. Am I clear? Right. So if I'm going to write here from something, suppose I'm writing here A, and I am dragging this A from here to here. A. So it's look like very small, understand, but it is two page data. Your first page is ending till here and second page starting here and ending till here. Okay, done? Got clear? So this is how you can set your page. Okay, and according to printer. Now I think you guys are knowing how to save your file. Go to this file menu, then save as command, then go to browser. Is that I'm going to browser, is that? And here if I'm going to give you so many options available here, in which options you want to save, understand? But for you, best one is Excel 97 2003 version, understand? So you can save in this one. Your file will run in all type of MS Word, understand? Clear? Okay. Right. So now we come to how to work with Excel sheet. Then how to add the data. So today I am going to show you a very simple aspects of entering the data here. Suppose very simple I am showing to you. Suppose I, in this cell I written 12 and in this cell I am going to write here 34. Okay, and in this cell suppose I want to sum of these two. So what I am going to write here, what the formula I am going to write here, I will go, I will write here equal to. What is equal to, I'll let you know later on, because a formula or a function always start with equal to. You so formula you're writing, then you have to start equal to, equal to. I'm writing 12 and then I'm writing plus, I'm writing here 30, I'm writing a 34, is it? Press enter key, you see answer is coming. Got clear? But if I want to change this one to 100, okay, this is not changing. Why not changing? Because this is our constant, these are not address of the cell. So instead of this one, if here I'm writing, if I'm going to give, what is the address of this 100? Yeah, B15. So I'm writing here B15. See, that will be selected for B. Plus, what is this? I'm going to write here C15. See, that will be selected for me. So now you see 134 is coming. Now yeah, I'm going to change this one to 300. Just check, it is automatically changing. Understand? That's why it is known as spread set. Every cell is live. So like that way you can insert here numerical facts and figure, and those numerical facts and figure will work automatically according to the formula and functions given, right? So is it, so anytime I open the sheet and anytime I can give a, suppose I'm going to give you a 5000 here, see automatically changing. So this is worksheet, right? Okay, so now suppose you have already saved this one, you can go here, you can print from here. If you have a printer, is it, you can copy the sheet, you can delete the sheets. I want to delete this sheet. What I'm going to do, have a right click here, you can have a rename, you can have a delete. I want to delete, I am deleting it. It is asking me that it will delete or not. I simply click delete. Again I am asking for this one to have a delete. I am see, deleted this sheet name. I want to rename. Suppose I want to rename, I am writing here class, I am writing here 9, what is the section here, C, 9C, oblique, okay, so let's see, C class 9C. I want to prepare here one more new sheet, I can have a rename here, I can write here class 9D. Just check it out. So two sheet I had created here, just see two names are here, class 9C, 9D, like that. I can delete at any time right here. Okay, clear? So these all are now fundamental. Now we will work how to enter the data in a worksheet. Okay, and one more thing, yeah, one very important discussion here. What is worksheet and workbook, is it? So we have saved the file here with name. What is name? SCS. I had given name of your class 9. So this is workbook. The name is workbook. Now this workbook, for this file only, this workbook consists of two worksheets. You see, these are the two worksheets. Right, so workbook, what is workbook? Workbook is a collection of what? Worksheets. Worksheet can increase, worksheet can decrease according to your file, according to your data, understand? Right, so, and again, worksheet consists of what? Column and rows. Intersection of column and rows make cell which is a representation of data of its type. Right, so, okay. And you go see all the fundamentals and its working part in running data. Now will come in the next class, is it? Next practical class, I'll make you to insert the data, how to create the data in that. Okay, so that's all for today's class. You go read your book for the fundamentals, right? Okay, see you in the next class. Okay, so be safe, protect yourself.